So we have let R be a ring of characteristic P. What does that mean? Number one thing you need to take note of is that when they say a ring has characteristic P, it means that if you let an element X come from the ring, then Px will be equal to zero. That is what this means. So it means that Px will be equal to zero. So prove that the Frobenius map, that is F map from R to R, then is equal to S raised to power P, is a ring homeomorphism. Now, what do we mean by a ring homeomorphism? So we want to prove that. What do we want to prove? Number one, if you take f of x plus y, it will be equal to f of x plus f of y. So that is what we want to prove for any two elements you pick from the ring. Then number two, since it's a ring, you know a ring has two binary operations. So we want to also prove that f of x, y is equal to f of x, f of y. So once we are able to prove these two things for all x and y in R, once we are able to, we can succeed in proving these two things, then we are through with the question. That means R is a ring homeomorphism. Now, f of x is equal to s raised to power p. I want to prove the first one. F of x plus y will be equal to what? F of x plus y will be equal to x plus y raised to the power of p. This will be equal to binomial expansion. If I want to write this in terms of summation, this will be equal to summation of k starting from 0 to p of, we have combination pk, p combination k, or it is also called binomial coefficient. Then we have s raised to power k, y raised to power p minus k. So what do we do from here? What we'll do from here is that we know that this is equal to, obviously, let me just quickly show you something here. We know that if I don't want to write this in summation form, s plus y raised to power p is actually equal to s raised to power p. We know that plus p s raised to power p minus 1 y, then plus p p minus 1 over 2 factorial s raised to power p minus 2 y squared. Then, and it goes on like that, you get to the last one. When you get to the second to the last, you have p again. This time around, you have x, y raised to power p minus 1, then plus y raised to power p. That is the normal binomial expansion. So I'm just trying to show you something here, and I can also write it in summation form. So before God and the truth of the matter is that apart from x raised to power p and y raised to power p, all the other terms of the expansion has p as its coefficient, and p is not at the denominator, so they can cancel out. But just hold that. So this one, I want to write it in this form. I want to write s raised to power p plus y raised to power p plus summation of k starting from 0. Now it will start from 0 again. It will start from 1, then to p minus 1. Then I have the binomial coefficient, p combination k, s raised to power k, then y raised to power of p minus k. What we have here, f of x plus y equals s plus y raised to power p, and is equal to this. So if you put when k is 0, you will get y raised to power p. And when you put when k is p, you will get x raised to power p. So that is why I removed the first term and the last term. So I will now be left with summation of k starting from 1 to p minus 1 of pk x raised to power k y raised to power p minus k. So if you don't understand what I have written here, just try to expand this. You will see that they are actually the same thing. Now, what is left for me to do in reality is for me to prove that this one will give me 0. So now we have summation of k starting from 1 to p minus 1 of pk. Then I have x raised to power k, y raised to power p minus k. So now what I need to do is look at pk, and don't forget 1 is less or equal to k less or equal to p minus 1. That is what k starts from 1 to p minus 1. So according to the definition of combination, this is p factorial all over p minus k factorial k factorial. So this will give me p minus 1 p minus 2 till you get to p minus k plus 1. Then you will have p minus k factorial all over p minus k factorial. Then k factorial, obviously, that is k minus 1 till you get to 1. So that's just from the definition of a combination and the factorial. So p minus k, we cancel p minus k. So this will be given, we have p open brackets p minus 1. P minus 2 till you get to P minus K plus 1. Then all over K factorial, that's K multiplied by K minus 1, K minus 2 till you get to 1. Since K is always greater than or equal to 1, the numerator we always have P. The numerator we always have P. So why would the numerator always have p? Because I have p. Obviously, when you have p factorial, one of the factor is always p. So take for instance, if k is 1, then I will have p minus 1 plus 1. P minus 1 plus 1 will give me p exactly. If k is 2, there is a p minus k plus 2. So there's p minus k plus 2 and on like that. So if you look at it very well, p will always be a factor at the numerator, and again, so it follows that p is a factor at the numerator. And again, since k is now less or equal to p minus 1, don't forget the highest value at the denominator is k. And k is always less or equal to p minus 1. So that means the highest value of k will be p minus 1. And because of that, p will never be a factor at the denominator. P is not a factor at the denominator. P is a factor here. So that means we can factorize p here. And once you are able to factorize, it means p is divisible, p can divide it. So it follows that p divides p combination k for k that is between 1 and p minus 1. So p will divide it, and since p can divide it, it means that it follows that p combination k is we always give you 0. It means that summation of k starting from 1 to p minus 1 of p combination k of x raised to power k y raised to power p minus k will always be 0 in the ring in R. Why will it be 0? Don't forget, since once you can factor out p and it is multiplying one of the elements of the ring, it will always be 0 because p is a characteristic of the ring. So therefore, f of x plus y, as I have written above, that is equal to x raised to power p plus y raised to power p plus summation of k starting from 1 to p minus 1 of p k s raised to power k y raised to power p minus k will actually be equal to s raised to power p plus y raised to power p plus 0. So I will be left with this, and this is exactly f of x plus f of y. So I am done with the proof of the first one. Don't forget, what we want to do is we want to show that f of x plus y is equal to f of x plus f of y. Then the second one, f of x y must be equal to f of x f of y. So the second thing I want to prove here is that f of x equal f of y. So for the second definition, f of x comma y, that will be equal to xy raised to power p, and that's obviously x raised to power p, y raised to power p. So, and that's f of x multiplying f of y. So since I'm able to show those two things, thus f is a ring homomorphism. And I'm done. Thank you very much.